Praise the Lord. My dear friends, today's first reading is from the book of 1 John chapter 3 and 4th chapters. The word very clearly says, God, He sent His only Son, Jesus, that we, the children who are living on this earth, may not perish, but we all should know the truth and live by God as God's children, to love God and to love one another. John says, those who are born of God are the children of God. And they know very well that the Son of God, He came down to the earth and He was born as a man. But people in the world look at God in two ways. Some see Him as God came to develop mankind, and they spend all their time and energy in building up mankind, like serving the poor, caring for the sick, and all that. And they do whatever the little they can do. They are happy. At the same time, when the poor or the suffering are denied justice by the world, they will become angry, upset. They will even try to divide people, and they will take even violence, and they will try to bring, in the name of justice, fights, struggle, and at the end even bloodshed. Some will call Jesus as the Lord. They will spend their time and energy in devotion, in praying, and even preaching. With that, they think that is their life. But God is saying, Jesus has come as the Lord, and His presence, His kingdom should come on this earth. Means we need to carry the Lord's love, the Lord's patience, the Lord's mercy, and the Lord's deliverance. We give it to the world and transform the world with the love of Jesus. When people don't accept us as we are, or people are still living in their own egoism, we remain patient and we try to convert them with love. And more than that, we kneel before God, seek God's presence, and with the power and presence of God, we transform this sinful, egoistic world. And this is called establishing the kingdom of God. With the love, with the holy presence and anointing of the Lord, we need to transform one another. And we should make everyone to think that we are the children of God. We are all part of one family of God. When that doesn't take place, the society can be divided. That's why John says, never, never forget, the Lord who is inside you is greater than anyone in the world. Don't be afraid of the world or the people in the world. You carry the Lord who is inside you to outside and bring transformation, liberation to the world. In the gospel of today, we find Jesus went away from Nazareth because people of Nazareth did not accept Jesus as the Lord, the Son of God. They said, oh, He is the Son of Mary. His brothers and sisters, cousins are there with us. We know where is He coming from. We don't know how did He get from wisdom and knowledge, all that. They did not accept Him. They saw Him as a worldly man. They saw Him as a man belonging to them, but not from God. which is not true. On the other hand, the Bible says, when people don't accept you, don't fight with them. Move out and go where people accept you and live as children of God. Or with the power and presence of the Lord, you transform those who don't accept you. Don't go for violence, or don't go for in the name of liberation and justice, trying to divide people. Jesus went to the other side of Jordan and he proclaimed in Galilee, Jerusalem, Capernaum area, and he proclaimed to them, God is love and you need to love one another. God is with each of us. And the people, they never saw where is he coming from and whose son he is. Rather, they accepted the message of the kingdom of God, that God loves and God lives in us and God is our Father. And when only when we live God among us, we will see each other with love. And the word of God spread. Jesus said, repent for your sin, that you are trying to live only for yourself. You are trying to live as a worldly man with what the world gives you. No, you can't live. You and I are basically come from God. We are here as God's children. And we are here to establish God's kingdom. That is, we all need to live in relationship with God. Love him. He is our Father. He is our God. And we need to see him in one another and care for each other and carry everybody together to the heavenly home. This world is passing away and all its glory is passing away. Don't fix your eyes on that which is passing away and fix your eyes on that which is eternal. Cling to light and transform the dark world. Cling to the power of God and bring the power and love of God to this loveless, sick world. May this world be transformed by the love, by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.